In this tutorial, I am going to walk through how to set up a Microsoft Word document according to MLA guidelines while using a PC. We'll first open Microsoft Word and click on Blank Document. The next step is to set up our page. To do so on a PC, we'll start with our margins. MLA requires 1-inch margins all the way around the page, so we'll go up to Layout, select Margins, and you see that they're already set to 1 inch all the way around or normal. A common default on Microsoft Word for PCs is to have an 8-point spacing after you hit return. That's what this box means. Make sure that you bump that down to 0. The next step is to go back to your Home tab in the ribbon and set your font. Many professors require Times New Roman 12-point font, so that's what we will select. I do also want to make sure that I have aligned my page to the left and that my font is double-spaced. Click on 2.0. Now we can begin typing. For MLA, the first part over to the left that you will type is your name, then your professor's name, then the title of the course, and then the date. And MLA requires that the date here be written out as day, full month, and then the year. The next line should include your title. Your title should be centered, and it should be something engaging that also tells your readers what they're going to be reading about. And then you can click Enter and left align again. To begin typing your introduction, you'll want to indent by using the tab. Now we're ready to move on and add our header. Our header should include our last name and page number. We always want to begin by inserting the page number first. To do so, go up to Insert in your ribbon and move over to the right until you find page number. We want it at the top of the page, all the way over to the right. And then we can type our last name in front of it with a space. You'll notice that my font here is different than the rest of my font, so I need to change that manually by highlighting it and changing it to Times New Roman 12-point font as well. Now I can double-click to get back down into the body, and I'm ready to begin my paper. Don't forget to save your file so that you don't lose any of the information. Simply go up to File, click Save As, title it something that you'll remember. Save it as Word, and make sure I know where I'm saving it. I like to save it to my desktop.